The Prime Minister of Uganda, Robin Nabanja, has today presented a statement to Parliament about incidents of brutality and high-handedness perpetrated by security officials on women members of Parliament in various parts of the country. Nabanja attributed the stand-ups in different districts where opposition women MPs were barred from organizing belated Women's Day celebrations to defiance of lawful orders.
Since April this year, at around 4 p.m., the district police commander of Vuma briefed police officers at the central police station about the unlawful assembly organized by Honorable Nakaziba Susan, the woman member of parliament for that district. The Honorable Speaker, I'm informed that the people had been mobilized to take a part in the Women's Day celebrations, which had not been cleared by the police.
Nabanja informed the House that incidents of confrontations between police and politicians are being investigated before appropriate action is taken.
We need to have a frank conversation like we are going to do today about, rather than putting all the blame on the law enforcers.
Where they said the Honorable Nakaziba was having an unauthorized meeting and moving from one place to the other. As a woman member of parliament, do I need to get permission to move from one constituency to the other? Don't I have the right to move from one sub-county to the other to meet my voters? They said she was chanting the noob slogans. Is it a crime?
However, the female legislators who suffered police brutality discredited the Prime Minister's report.
All women celebrations, the woman MP is the guest of honor. And she's saying in the report that the disagreement arose from failing to agree on who the guest of honor is. Yet I was there. Yet I am here as the woman member of parliament. And let me say also this. In the district, in the Mitiana district, the district executive communicated the venue for the function.
I had gotten clearance from all security offices, beginning with the RDC, the DSO, the RPC, and the DPC.
MPs pointed to the resident district commissioners, RDCs, who have been granted a lot of power to the extent of disregarding the constitution.
The function was postponed with the report the RCC gave, that is Peter Peck's Park, on hearing that the chief guest of the day is Honorable Cecilia Ogwal. And he is on record saying he will never, as long as he's the RCC of Soroti City, he will never allow an opposition member to preside over a national function. So
nowhere they have got powers to ensure that even local governments are not in position to commission their projects apart from only inviting RDCs as chief guests. I'm getting complaints from mayors, from district chairpersons and other leaders that RDCs are failing them to move on because they feel they are the bosses.
NRM female legislators also testified that the situation is not any different in their constituencies.
Comfortable with, right on a speaker, is when they thump their chests that they will not allow me to organize the women's celebrations. When we keep quiet, right on a speaker, it's not because we are dense or stupid. We are human and we want them to behave likewise.
I always get a problem, like this year when I was trying to organize for the function, I'd even invited the right honorable prime minister to be the chief guest. The office of the RDC tried to block me, yet I'm NRM. Even they called security. By the time I left Kampala, I went and phoned when they had come out with 6 resolutions, stopping me that they are not aware of the function, and yet it was declared by His Excellency in 2006.
The House resolved that the Minister for Presidency takes appropriate action against errant RDCs and district women representatives given space to take charge of Women's Day activities in their districts.
All your RDCs who are defiant must be brought to book. And we want a report in this House on which RDCs you have brought to book. The money, the 3 million that was pledged in this House that would go to all the districts. We need a report on which district has gotten the money and which one has not gotten the money and reason why it has not gotten the money.
Story by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.